So today we are going to discuss about that seed movement at international level. So this is mainly regarding that what systems we need to follow for export of our material to other country. So in that angle, organizations related to that seed at international level, we are going to discuss that so many organizations are involved with reference to certifying the seeds and also to test the quality of the seeds and also protection of the cultivars. So related to all these things, so many organizations are involved in that. One of the organization is that OECD, that is Organization for Economic Cooperation Development. So they are dealing with a variety of product. In that, one of the product is a seed. So for seed also, they are having certification systems. Once that our seed materials are certified under OECD scheme, that material is eligible to export to other European countries. And also that under OECD scheme, so many member countries are there. So among the all the member countries, we can go for export of that material. So that previous two sessions we were discussed about various aspects of the seeds and supply chain systems and what are all the activity taken care by the State Agriculture University like TNAU and Department of Agriculture and everything we were discussed, and seed planning and that systems availability for achieving that seed plan. So all those things and we were discussing in the previous class. So in all the cases we are working for production of the quality seeds. So whatever that seeds are produced, if the seeds sown in the field has not the capacity to produce an abundant crop, means all the beneficial climate soil conditions are meaningless and the use of other input is a waste of money. So this course very clearly indicates that seed is a very, very important and vital input. So this slides also in the first class itself I have shown. So this is a seed economy at the world level. So estimated value of domestic seed market. So this shows the market potential of seeds for in various countries. India is the fifth largest domestic seed market in the world. It handles the quantum of the seed material to the worth of $2,000 million. And also it's very fastly that Indian seed sector also growing. The annual growth rate also is 17%. So this is the global level. So what are all the country they are concentrating on? Seed production is given in a red color, or I mean orange color dot. So more than 70 countries are involved in the seed production. So they are producing now, they are producing seeds not only for the purpose of fulfilling their requirement. In addition to their requirement, they are also producing excess quantity. That excess quantity material and all they are exporting to other country for the purpose of getting more foreign money. So that will strengthen their financial position of that country. So in that angle, that Europe, American countries, particularly that North American countries, they are concentrating on seed production activity. So all those seeds were exported to other country. So now here the thing is, they are exporting that material. Once you are aiming for export of your material to other country, means your material must be certified by the international organizations. At present in India, we are having that seed certification system. So under seed certification system, we are having Indian minimum seed certification standard. So by the way of testing that quality of the seeds, we are ensuring the quality standards prescribed in the Indian minimum seed certification standard. So that standard is that way tested material is we can distribute only within our country. If you are aiming for export of your material to other country, means definitely your material must fulfill the requirement of the other countries also. Under that situation only we need to go for or we need to follow that international seed certification system. So under this case, that so many certifying agencies are there, like OECD, that is Organization for Economic Cooperation Development, and Association of Seed Certification Association of Seed Certification Agency. So these agencies are they are doing certification work for the seed material. Mainly they are verifying the varietal identity and purity, all those things they are checking. That certification systems also almost equal that of our seed certification systems. Similarly, that another thing also very important, if you go for export or import of the material, that is a phytosanitary measures. So that also we have to ensure. So as on date, in our seed certification system, we are checking the quality of the seeds with reference to physical purity, genetic purity, germination, and moisture content. We never bother about that seed health status. That also is not mandatory as far as that Indian minimum seed certification standard is concerned. But if you go for that export of our material, the importing country, they are demanding seed health status of also. And also your material should be free of any pest and diseases and wheat seed material. So under this case, we have to get that phytosanitary certificate also, that and all taken care by the IPPC, SPS, and the NPPO. So those organizations deal with that phytosanitary measures. And that organization like International Seed Testing Agency, they are responsible for checking the quality of the seeds. They are not doing any certification system. They are also giving things that is only for they are testing the quality of the seeds based on the testing protocols and testing methodology, and based on the quality standards also they are having. So based on that, they are also giving a certificate for the seeds. So ISTA also responsible for testing the quality and issuing the certificate. That ISTA certificate also useful for moving up our seed from one country to another country. The above all, once you decided to export or import, particularly decided to export your material to other country, your material should be protected. So that protection is very much important. So then only that rights of that material will be with us. Or otherwise, once they receive the material, after that they will go for multiplication without getting material further from you. They will multiply and they will distribute and they will do. Once your material is protected, so the rights will be retained with you. That is particularly the protection and distribution rights will be with you. And whoever interested to further produce and distribute, they are in a position to pay some of the royalty to you. So under that situation, that agency like UPOV is a UPOV, it's a agency related to that protection of plant varieties. And in India also we are having one protection authority that is equal to that UPOV, that is a PPVFRA. So these are all the things very important with reference to the movement of the seeds at the international level. I wanted to recollect some information again. So that is OECD and AOSCA, they are responsible for a certification system. They are having a certification system to certify your seeds. Once that seed is certified either under OECD or AOSCA, we can export those material to that member countries of that particular OECD or AOSCA. So it's kind of international seed certification system. Then ISTA responsible for that development of the seed testing protocols and that sampling procedures. If you adapt those two and your material is test verified and ISTA accredited laboratory, they are also giving a certificate. With after getting that certificate, you can export your material to other country. That is the role of the ISTA. And then phytosanitary measures, that is a very important aspect with reference to that export of your material. And then UPOV, that deal with the varietal protection systems. So now we can discuss about that OECD in comparison with the Indian minimum seed certification system. So the OECD schemes provide an international framework for certification of agriculture seeds moving at international trade, particularly it's a certification system. So this system was established in the year 1958. It's a combination of factors including fast growing sea trade and regulatory harmonization in Europe and the support of the private seed industry they started. So the main objective of this particular OECD scheme is concerned mainly to encourage the use of seeds of consistently high quality in participating country and to authorize the use of labels and certificate for seed produced and processed for international trade in according to agreed principles. So that OECD also have a set of principles. As per that principles, the quality of the seeds will be verified both field level as well as in the seed level. Once that the seed material fulfill the requirement, automatically that seed will be given with certificate. With that certificate, we can go for export of that material to the participating country. So this is the main aim of this OECD. So OECD also a kind of a seed certification system. So established in the year 1958. So under OECD scheme, so 59 countries are there, particularly in the seed scheme. So under seed scheme, 7 schemes are there, 6 schemes that related to agriculture species, 1 scheme related to vegetables. Certification is mainly based on the set of rules and regulations, and assessment also based on the agreed principles that quality will be assessed. India joined 5 schemes in September 2008. Joint Secretary Seeds of Government of India is National Designated Authority for OECD Schemes. Apart from National Level Designated Authority, 10 Designated Authorities also there for certain states. They are responsible for monitoring of the OECD scheme related activities in their area of operations. So under OECD schemes, 19 crops of our India is enrolled. Out of 19 crops, 61 varieties are listed in the OECD scheme. So in the 61 varieties, you can go for that seed production, the OECD schemes. Once your seed fulfill the requirement of the OECD testing protocols, automatically you can get the certificate. With that certificate, you can go for export of your material to other country. So this is the main thing. So under OECD scheme, so these are all the crops are included. So the cereal seeds we can produce, maize and sorghum seeds, vegetable seeds, grass and legume seeds, cruciferous seeds, and other oil or fiber species seeds, floriculture plant materials also we can produce. On 21st September 2007, India applied for above schemes, and 2008 they joined in 5 schemes. So these are all the 10 different designated authority in India to mainly to undertake the certification of the OECD seed schemes. So that Karnataka State Seed Certification Agency, that area of operation is Karnataka and Kerala. Andhra Pradesh State Seed Certification Agency, that is a designated authority. They are responsible for taking care of the OECD scheme operation in Andhra Pradesh, Orisha and Chhattisgarh. And Directorate of Seed Certification, Government of Tamil Nadu, they are responsible for that OECD scheme certification system in Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. Then Maharashtra State Seed Certification Agency, so that area of operation is Maharashtra, Gujarat, Daman Diu, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, and Rajasthan State Seed Certification Agency. So their area of operation is Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. Uttarakhand State Seed Certification Agency, the area of operation is Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, and Himachal Pradesh. And then Uttar Pradesh State Seed Certification Agency, so the area of operation Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, and Haryana State Seed Certification Agency, Haryana, Punjab, Chandigarh, and Jammu and Kashmir, their area of operation. Bihar State Seed Certification Agency, that area of operation is Bihar, Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Then Assam State Seed Certification Agency, all 7 northeastern states including Sikkim. So these are all the 10 designated authority responsible for effective implementation of the OECD schemes in India. So in the implementation of the schemes, so the OECD schemes, that set out some rules and legal framework with reference to that field level operation, that is inspection related operation and testing related protocols. So all these principles accepted by the participating countries with reference to production, processing and trade. So here also we have different categories of seeds. Already in Indian system of seed certification, we have Breeder Seed Foundation certified. Like that, in this case also different categories of seeds are available, and minimum varietal purity standard also set out, like that of our system, and varietality also they given us standards, and the seed production inspection related legal framework also they formulated, and labeling everything also there in the OECD schemes. Also we are going to discuss all the items in comparison with the Indian minimum seed certification process one by one. And the benefit of that international seed certification, the main benefit is this improve the market access and facilitate trade in seeds. So once you get OECD seed certifications, automatically we can export your material to other country without any problems. Particularly among the member countries, you can export the material. So automatically this will improve the market access and also facilitate the trade, and reduce the technical barrier also. If some other, if you follow that Indian minimum seed certification standard, after getting that foundation tag or certificate tag, if you go for that export of that material, they will ask you so many other things. Once you follow these international accepted protocol, there won't be any questions among the member countries. Simply you can export your materials. So harmonization of certification process, because everybody accepted, 56 countries are there, means all the 56 countries are accepted that as certification protocol. So once your material fulfill all the certification protocols, there won't be any question, further question. You can simply export or import material, and you are also given with international recognized labels and certificates. And another main advantage is the traceability of the seed also very possible from where this particular material is received. So that traceability and passport details, everything will be maintained in a paka manner. So we can easily trace the origin of that seed material. So these are all the advantage of that one. Then simplify international rules. So by the way of consulting with all the countries, they evolved rules and regulations. All those rules and regulations were accepted by all the member countries. So that is the advantage. Then use of this particular scheme both for domestic and international purpose. Suppose your material is not get lifted by the that importing country, means you are in a position to distribute your material within the country also, in such a way that they formulated the policies and rules and regulations. So it's a kind of a global level seed certification system. So these are all the benefits of that international seed certification. Then enhance the cooperation between the countries and the public and private sector also. So this enhance the cooperations among the countries, and that's also another advantage. Then sharing of the best practices among the member countries with reference to that sharing of that field inspection problems and how they solve that particular problems, and remedies similarly for testing protocol. So all those things and all possible. So based on that, if at all anything needed, based on the requirement or based on the experience, they can go for that periodical changing of that protocol also. So these are all the advantages of that international seed certification systems. So coming back to this OECD system, I already told you here also we have different categories of seeds. So that different categories of seeds, like pre-basic seeds, basic seeds and certified seeds. So similar kind of categories also there in Indian minimum seed certification system, that is a breeder seed, foundation and certified seed. So in OECD scheme, the pre-basic seed, that is equivalent to our breeder seed, the basic seed is equivalent to our foundation seed, certified seed is equivalent to our certified seeds. So we can discuss that OECD scheme in comparison with Indian minimum seed certification standard. So then only you can clearly understood that OECD schemes. where that scheme is differed from our Indian minimum seat certification standard. So that already I told you that categories of seats. So here that categories of seats for OECD and Indian minimum seat certification standard also given. In the case of OECD, the first material is a pre-basic seats. That pre-basic seats are given with white color with a diagonal violet stripe, that label. Whereas that the pre-basic seat equivalent material is under Indian minimum seat certification standard is a better seat. The dimension is 12 into 6 centimeter. Mostly the dimension related questions occur in the ICR exams. So the better seat, the tag dimension is 12 into 6 centimeter. The color is golden yellow. So the pre-basic seat is equal to our beta seat. The next category of OECD seat is basic seat. The color of the label is white. So this is equal to our foundation seat. So the dimension of our foundation seat tag is 15 into 7.5 centimeter. The color also same thing, white. Next to that basic seat under OECD scheme, certified seat, first generation, the color is blue. So this is equal to our certified seat. In Indian minimum seat certification standard, the certified seat tag dimension is 15 into 7.5 centimeter. That color is assured blue in color. Next to that certified seat first generation under OECD scheme, certified seat only, but we have to mention that that number of generation. If it is first second generation, means we have to merit as certified seat second generation. If you go for further multiplication, the subsequent generation must be mentioned. The color of the label also red color. This is not applicable for sugar and powder wheat. So that is certified seed stage alone they will permit. So they never allow to go further second generation or subsequent generations in the case of sugar and powder wheat. So the certified seed is equal to our certified seeds. Here also the same thing, that is CS1, CS2, like that. So these are all the category. Other than that, in our system we have a TFL seed, truthfully labeled seeds. Actually these seeds not comes under the certification systems. So the producer, they will produce the material. After that the quality will be checked. Once that quality is fulfilled the Indian minimum seed certification standard, the producer itself, they can produce a label. So that is a labeled seeds. So that color is opal green. So in the case of OECD scheme, the category is there, that is not finally certified seeds. Actually this also a certified seed material. So the seeds produced under OECD scheme, so the seed material fulfilled the field requirement before the test result came, the material may be exported to other countries. So that kind of material is normally known as a not finally certified seed material. So before getting that result for the seed material that may be exported to other country, that is a not finally certified seeds, that is given with the gray color thing. So this is OECD labels of various things. I already told you that the color and everything. In all the certificate, this side, black color stripes will be there. Whatever may be that material. So pre-basic material or basic material or generation certified seed material, black color stripes with 3 centimeter things will be there. So in Indian minimum seed certification standard, the label shall be made durable material, that is a thick paper with the cloth lining will be there, and wax coated things also there. Whereas in the OECD scheme, the labels are strong enough. Mainly it's this material go at international level, there are a lot of chances are for getting damaged. So mainly to prevent the damage, this material is normally made out of a strong material. And the shape of that tag and all, in Indian minimum seat certification standard, it's a rectangular shape. Both the side of the tag should be printed, colored, respective of the class of the seats. Whereas OECD tag also rectangular shape. One end of the label should be over printed and black color, minimum distance of 3 centimeter. That is this one. Minimum distance of 3 centimeter. In all the categories, they will leave 3 centimeter black color things, leaving rest of the label colored. In Indian minimum seat certification standard, the tag for printing purpose we are using that English, whereas OECD scheme either English as well as French language will be used. So this is a purity level in comparison with Indian Minimum Six Certification Standard. In the case of Indian Minimum Six Certification Standard for breeder seed, we are demanding 100% genetic purity and physical purity, foundation 99%, certified seed on 98%. Similarly, in the case of OECD schemes also, if it is a free basic seed material, there we are demanding 100%. If it is a basic seed material, 99.9%, we have to maintain the volatile purity. Certified seeds, we have to maintain 99.7%. In the case of hybrid, that may be vary among the species, that ranges in between 95% to 99.5%. Whereas in the case of Indian Minimum Seed Certification Standard, for hybrid, that volatile purity is ranges between 90% to 95%, that also vary among the species. So this is with reference to varietal purity regarding that OECD as well as Indian Minimum Seed Certification Standard. So that label information regarding that tag information, that Indian Minimum Seed Certification Standard white color, blue color or something, that carry these information: tag number, class of seeds, kind, certification number, variety, all those things will be there. Whereas in the case of OECD scheme, name and address of the national level designated authority, species name, varietal denomination, category, whether it's a free basic seed, basic seeds or a certified seeds, lot reference number, country of production, region of productions, statement of repacking and relabeling. So this also very very important, repacking and relabeling. Whereas in the case of a OECD, the seed produced under OECD scheme, they are permitting repacking and relabeling and all they are permitting. Whereas under Indian system of seed certification, once the tagging is over, we should not do that repacking and all. So because of that kind of information not there in our system. Whereas here in the OECD label, the statement of repacking and relabeling is there. So with reference to the different category of seeds, already you may aware of that class of seed and their who is responsible for production. So similarly, that OECD scheme seed category also taken care by the different authority. So equivalent to our nucleus seeds and the OECD scheme, they are having a breeders maintenance material. They are having a seed material, the name of breeders maintenance seed material, and that material is mainly checked against DUS centers for varietal purity. DUS means distinctness, uniformity and stability. Every time that will be checked for the varietal purity, and that will carry that carrier supplies label, that also have a labels controlled and maintained by the breeders or maintainer. So the maintainer or breeder, they're responsible for maintaining of that material. And so this is used for multiplication of the pre-basic seed material. So already you people are aware of that nucleus seeds, so that a concerned breeder is eligible to produce and they have to maintain, and that will be used for breeder seed production. So under again OECD scheme, pre-basic seed material, white color label, diagonal white color stripes that given. So controlled by official certification authority. So even though that pre-basic seeds are equal to our breeder seeds, here that seed multiplication, everything is taken care by the officials, not by the breeders. Whereas in the case of breeder seeds, that monitoring and controlling everything is taken care by the breeders, not by the officials. So that is a main thing. Whereas in the pre-basic seeds, that material will be handed over to the officials and maintainers, not by the breeders. So that will be multiplied. That multiplied material is not used for commercial purpose, not for sale. So that will be used for that basic seed multiplication purpose. So basic seed under OECD scheme, that is equal to our foundation seeds. So here that controlled by official certification authority, undertake a pre-control test. Pre-control test means that the quality will be verified, genetic purity, everything will be verified. Then only that tag will be given. Cannot be again, this one also cannot be commercialized, not for sale. Produced officially by the recognized institute or organization alone. and not here there won't be any validity and all. Whereas in the case of a foundation seed and certified seeds, we are specifying 9 months of validity. Here not that case, and OECD scheme, so no such validity is there. Here that basic seeds are mainly produced by the officials, by the recognized institute or organizations. Whereas in the case of a foundation seeds, mainly that NSC or AD extension. Apart from that, we are also permitting seed growers and private people also to involve in the foundation seed production. Whereas in the case of a basic seed material production, only that officials by the recognized institute and organization alone is empowered. Another difference, no validity period for seeds, whereas foundation seeds, so 9 months is a validity. Subsequently, again, that will be revalidated for another 6 months. Then another category of seed under OECD scheme is certified seeds. If it is a C1 first generation, mean blue color, C2 red color label, whereas here water may be, whether it's a CS1 or CS2, that will be given with blue color label. So here not under breeder maintenance control, however consulted for number. So these particular certified seeds not under the breeder's control. So the designated authority and controlling authority undertake the quality control measures. Particularly, they will do that post control test, and also they will work for the provision of the patent royalty for the maintenance and breeders, and used for commercial multiplication and sales. So this one also don't have any validity periods. So these are all the different category. Apart from that, not finally certified seed material. So this is at field level that inspection is over. So before that, getting that test result, material is exported to other country, means that is not finally certified seed material. So that is given with a gray color label. This is almost equal to our TFL seed material. Apart from not finally certified seed material, standard seeds also there under OECD schemes, that is given with a dark yellow color label. So mainly existing vegetable seed scheme. So the standard seed is available mainly in the vegetable seed scheme, and that declared by the suppliers as being true to the variety and satisfied to the varietal purity. So this also like that of our TFL seed. So here that purity everything is declared by the suppliers, but it should be confirmed the appropriate condition in the scheme. So standard seed, so this is mainly for vegetable seed scheme. So this is also equal to our TFL seed. So equivalent kind of category is not there in our Indian minimum seed certification standard. Then varietal eligibility for multiplication of the seed under OECD schemes. So as far as that Indian minimum seed certification systems, the eligibility of the seed to getting into the certification is notification under Section 5 of the Seed Act. Whereas for OECD schemes, so whatever that seeds registered in the national catalog variety, all those varieties are eligible to multiply under OECD scheme. Apart from that, all the country, they should have a national list of varieties under the OECD schemes. They should have a national list of varieties under OECD schemes. So in that variety alone, we can go for seed production under OECD schemes. Things related to seed lot sampling. So in the case of Indian minimum seed certification standard, in the case of foundation and certified seeds, once that processing everything is over, that seed certification officer, they will take the sample. That sample will be submitted for the seed testing. Whereas under OECD scheme, and the samplers are there, and they are having a samplers. So the samplers alone, and the samplers are empowered to take the sample. That sample will be submitted. Side by side, the official supervisors also take the sample and check the accuracy of the samples taken by the samplers. Whereas in the Indian minimum seed certification standard, and that the government official, that is SCO, is responsible. Whereas in the case of OECD scheme, they are recognizing, or they are authorizing some person as a sampler. That samplers will take the samples. The samplers will be supervised by the official supervisors in order to check the genuineness of the samplers. that 5% of the sample taken by the samplers will be cross-verified by the official seed samplers also. Regarding that free and forced control test, as far as that Indian minimum seed certification standard is concerned, we normally conduct that GOT wherever it is prerequisite. No provision for free and post control test. Whereas in the case of OECD scheme, free control test is compulsory for free basic and basic seed material. Free control test is compulsory. A part of every sample of basic seed and 5 to 10% of the certified seed sample checked in a post control test conducted immediately or in the following season. So this is very, very important and one of the main difference. Then issue of certificates. Normally, under Indian Minimum Seed Certification Standard, Beta Seeds, the concerned scientist involved in the production, he or she himself will prepare a certificate that is added. Yellow color tag will be added. The foundation certified seeds, the certificate will be issued by the ADI seed certification. Whereas under OECD scheme, the designated authority, they are responsible for issue of a certificate for each lot of a pre basic, basic and certified seeds approved under the scheme. Planting of lots. Planting of lots means, so example, you are having one seed lot of paddy, and that is a Trichy one. So the same person having a Trichy one paddy seed in another lot. So for certification, as per the certification norms, if it is a paddy, that should have a 80% germination. One particular lot that want to have a 90% germination, another one have 70% germination. So the first lot is automatically eligible for certification, whereas the second lot is not eligible due to lack of the germination. So if it is planting is permitted, that producer, they can go for mixing up that lot having 90% germination with mixing up lot having 70%. By that way, they can adjust germination value to the level of 80%. So if it is 80%, automatically that will be eligible for certification. So this is a planting. So this kind of planting is not permitted under Indian Minimum Seed Certification Standard in all the cases, whereas planting is permitted in the case of a OECD scheme. So that is the advantage of this particular system. The another thing with reference to that Indian Minimum Seed Certification Standard is concerned, no provision for repacking and relabeling. So once that that seed is packed and tagged, if you open up that one, that should be used for sowing purpose, or that should be used for revalidation or resampling purpose. Whereas under OECD scheme, the provisions are there for repacking and relabeling in another country. After import of that material, they can go for the repacking and relabeling. So that is possible in the case of a OECD seed scheme. Then reference number of the certificate and seed lot. So normally in the case of Indian Minimum Seed Certification Standard, we are giving a seed lot number, so that always start with the month and year of harvest, followed by the production location code, that seed lot number and financial year, like that. Whereas in the case of a OECD scheme, the three letter country code as per the ISO first one, then followed by the initial letter of the designated authority and reference number of the lot number, uniform digit 001999, like that. That start with 001 and go with 99, and code letter is used for indicate the harvest year. So this is this kind of system they are following, that is three letter country code as per ISO standard, followed by initial letter of the designated authority, then number of that particular year, and then code letters used to indicate the harvest years. So the code number is given for every year. And then specimen certificate and analysis results. So in Indian standard, no such reference is specified. Specimen certificate, all those things, tag number only is normally used. Indian minimum Indian system certification tag and labels are issued, whereas OECD statement or repacking and relabeling is given. Additionally, in OECD, only number of containers and declared weight of the lot is given, And OECD is the orange certificate also. Sometimes they are given. Is the orange certificate? I will come to that one while we are discussing about the ISTA. Then procedure for extension of the schemes not available in Indian systems. Whereas procedure for extension of the scheme is included every year, we can keep on adding that varieties and also whatever that variety already there in the certification systems, and continuously we can go for that production and distribution of the seed material. And then coming back to that field level operations, in the case of Indian minimum seed certification standard, the land selections normally will follow that selected land should not be cultivated with other variety of the same crop in the previous season, other variety of the same crop in the previous season. That is a top selection process we are following. The main purpose is that selected land should be free from pollinator plants. Whereas in the case of a OECD scheme, they are also having a similar kind of some rules with reference to selection of the land. If it is a cruciferous species you are interested to seed production, means that field should not be cultivated with any cruciferous species for the first 5 years, for other species 2 years. If it is a hybrid seeds, means hybrid seeds may not be grown on the same field in the successive years. So these are all the things with reference to that land selection. Then isolation distance, so here that once that isolation is specified, the same thing we have to follow. Whereas here that isolation distance, the under OECD schemes we can modify. The only thing is sufficient protection from undesirable pollen or other possibility of cross fertilization should be eliminated. There won't be any hard and fast rules with reference to that isolation distance, but the thing is that anyhow sufficient protection must be there. Seed standards, so here that maximum permissible limit for objectionable wheat plants is there in Indian minimum seed certification systems. Say example, for foundation seed, most of the cases the maximum permissible limit is 0.01%, certified seed 0.02%. similarly, for insect damage also some provisions are there under Indian minimum seed certification standard. Both for foundation certified seeds, in the case of maize and legume, the maximum permissible insect damage is 1%, whereas other crop seed 0.5%. No such maximum permissible limit for insect damage is there in the OECD scheme, and also designated disease wheat seeds, all those things are not there. Seed crop inspection for varieties under Indian minimum seed certification system, 2 to 4 inspection is followed. Whereas in the OECD schemes, at least one field inspection of each seed crop after the emergence of the inflorescence. So that is the OECD scheme with reference to field inspection. For a hybrid, in case of Indian minimum seed certification standard, normally 3 to 4 inspection. Whereas in the case of OECD scheme, for hybrid and parental line, 3 inspection is must. Then official supervision. So official supervision is mainly taken care by the SCOs, whereas in the OECD scheme, non-official inspectors are also allowed to operate for field inspection. So they are affiliate some private person also. That person also will do that inspection and all. That is a thing. Then another main difference also there with reference to that op types. In the case of Indian minimum seed certification standard, some of the crop maximum permissible limit is 0.05% for foundation, certified seed is 0.2%. Whereas in the case of basic seeds, one number of op type in every 30 square meter area, certified seeds 1 in 10 square meter areas. So this is for OECD scheme with reference to op type. Male sterile seed parent, no such specifications are there in Indian minimum seed certification standard, whereas some specifications are there for OECD scheme. So male sterile seed parents may be mixed with fully fertile seed parent, the ratio of 2:1. Downgrading seed glasses in the case of Indian minimum seed certification standard here allowed, but not be applicable in case of a hybrid and a parental material. If it is a varietal seed production, there the downgrading is permitted. In the OECD scheme, no provision is made for both variety and hybrids. So this is with reference to field inspection for vegetable seeds. how many number of plants need to observe for each count. So the details are given in comparison with our Indian minimum seed certification standard and OECD standard, both for foundation and certified seed. There also basic and certified seeds. So these are all the datas. Again, this also number of field count for crops. Then op types and varietal identification, disease and number of wheat seeds for different category. Normally in OECD scheme, minimum limit for weeds and disease, all those things are not available. Whereas Indian minimum seed certification standard, things are there. And then with reference to that seed analysis, Indian minimum seed certification standard, the seed sample analysis in the notified seed testing laboratory. The seeds are test verified as per the seed testing manual approved by the Central Seed Committee as per the Indian Minimum Seed Certification Standard. Whereas OECD schemes, the seeds are analyzed only in authorized and designated laboratories, and also only designated authority alone analyzes the seed quality. That for analyzing the seed quality, they will follow internationally accepted protocols. Then seed sample storage. So after giving a result, the remaining quantity of the seed sample should be stored in the laboratory at least for minimum period of time. On Indian minimum seed certification standard, the curd sample will be kept in under storage for 2 years. Suppose the lot is rejected or the the test result in the purview of the court means, that case we have to preserve the material for 4 years. Whereas in the case of OECD scheme, that sample, remaining sample, should be stored for possible a long period of times under controlled conditions. If it is a basic seeds, so at least that third sample should be stored for 1 year. So these are all the list of variety identified for OECD seed scheme from an Indian sites. So the first variety PPT.04, like that so many varieties are there. Regarding our variety in groundnut, you can see that the TME2 is there. And in the case of tomato, you can see that PKM1. So these are all the variety. So these are all the varieties are already listed in the OECD schemes. If you are interested to produce and export your material to other country, you can take up that seed production operation in all these crops, and your field should be registered with the designated authority of the OECD. So OECD, once you register, automatically they will come for the inspection and the sample will be taken and that will be test verified. Everything is fulfilled, automatically you can export your material to other country. So this will give you a better income and make this seed business more income generative. So this is a scheme right now we are following under Indian minimum seed certification standard for the purpose of producing different class of seeds. So under OECD schemes also we have a maximum seed lot size. In Indian minimum seed certification standard also we have a maximum seed lot size. In the case of maize, that maximum seed lot size is 40,000 kg, and small size seed 10,000 kg, the same only here also. And some other crop, they specified that isolation distance also. For basic seeds, in the case of maize 200 meter, certified seed 200 meter, hybrid 200 meter, for sorghum 400 meter, and certified seed 200 meter, for hybrid 300 meters. And varietal purity standards also they are given. And the GOT test and relevant genetic purity level also they are given. So these are all the things with reference to that OECD scheme is concerned. It's a very good schemes. Once we produce that material under these schemes, we can export our material to other country. So with that I wish to complete giving information regarding that OECD. So in the next class we can discuss about that things related to ISTA.